Hello students, I welcome you all to this presentation on MCB testing experiment. Now let us see the aim of this experiment. The aim of this experiment is to study the operation of an MCB and plot its operating characteristics. Now before we go into the experiment, let us first understand what is meant by an MCB. MCB stands for Miniature Circuit Breaker. It is an electromechanical protective device which automatically opens the electrical circuit during overload or short circuit conditions. So you can see there are some of the images of this MCB, like single pole MCB, two pole MCB, four pole MCB, like that. Now let us understand what are the main parts of MCB and how it operates. We'll see a short video on the construction and operation of MCB. Hello students, now I'll show you the main parts of an MCB and how they function. Now to start with, let us see the external components. This is the operating knob. This is the operating knob. This is the incoming terminal. And this is the outgoing terminal. Now the internal parts are like this. You can see the silver metal piece, that is the fixed contact. This copper strip, what you see, that is the movable contact. And in the bottom, there's a strip here that is called as bimetallic strip. And then you have this magnetic coil, or you can call it a solenoid coil. And this is the arc chamber. And there is a operating mechanism. There's a spring here with an operating mechanism. So under normal condition, when you switch on this MCB, you can see the moving contact comes in contact with the fixed contact. So this is in contact now. So what happens? The supply will enter this incoming terminal. It will pass through the bimetallic strip, then through the fixed and moving contact, and then through this solenoid coil, and it will exit from the outgoing terminal. So under normal condition, the fixed and moving contact will be in place like this. Now let us understand what happens when there is an overload. When there is an overload, the current will flow through this bimetallic strip. When this bimetallic strip carries overcurrent, it will get heated up and it will operate this opening mechanism like this, and thereby it will open the contact here and interrupt the circuit. When the MCB trips like this, we call it as a thermal trip. Now let us understand how the MCB works under short circuit condition. Under short circuit condition, this solenoid coil, or a magnetic coil we call it as, this is made up of few turns of thick copper wire. When there is a short circuit, this magnetic coil gets energized and the plunger inside it will hit this mechanism instantaneously. When it hits the mechanism, the circuit breaker will trip open like this. When the MCB trips like this, then we call it as a magnetic trip. For a magnetic trip, it will be instantaneous. When there is a short circuit, the trip will happen instantaneous. Whereas for thermal trip, this bimetal strip will get slowly heated up, and when it starts bending, it will take some time. And then afterwards it will
trip. So this we call it as thermal trip, whereas the operation due to this magnetic coil we call it as magnetic trip. And when there is a tripping operation, then there will be some arc formed in this gap which will be quenched by this arc chamber. This is how a MCB operates.
I hope you have understood the construction and operation of the MCB. Now, we'll try to understand a little bit more fundamentals about MCB, like characteristics of MCB, different types or classes of MCB in the coming slides. So MCB has got two characteristics. One is inverse time characteristics, another is instantaneous characteristics. This was shown in the video to you, what is meant by inverse time characteristics and what is meant by instantaneous characteristics. As I mentioned in the video, whenever there's an overload, the bimetal strip will operate, and there the bimetal strip will take time to bend and it will trip the circuit. And as and when the current is more, the time taken for tripping will be less. So that is why on overload condition, the MCB has the characteristics of inverse time characteristics. Whereas when there is a short circuit, it has got instantaneous characteristics. That means to say, when there is a short circuit, the MCB trips immediately. This slide shows the trip curves for various classes of MCB. You can see the curves shown here are for class B, class C and class D. Now what are these class B, class C and class D? These are nothing but classification of MCBs based on the fault current rating at which the MCB trips on magnetic trip, that is instantaneously. So if you observe here, the class B, up to certain value of current, it follows the inverse time characteristic curve. Beyond say 3 times the rated current of the MCB, anything up to 5 times the rated current of MCB, it will follow magnetic trip. So such MCBs are classified under class B. Likewise, if the MCB trips magnetically, that is instantaneously, any thing between 5 to 10 times the rated current, they are classified as class C. Likewise, any rating from 10 times to 20 times the rating of the MCB, if it trips instantaneously, they are classified as class D MCB. Whatever may be the class, up to some values, it will follow inverse curve, and beyond the specified range, it will follow the instantaneous characteristic curve. So this is about the trip curves of different classes of MCB. And one more thing is, based on this one, it will find its application. I will show the other types of MCB with application in the next slide. So in this slide, you can see, as I explained, class B falls under this category where the trip current is say 3 to 5 times the rated current. These are suitable for domestic application where the load is resistive. Most of it is resistive, a very small inductive load may be there and very low surges will be there. So this is suitable for such applications. Whereas class C, it has this range where 5 to 10 times the rated current. These are also suitable for domestic application as well as applications where there are small inductive loads and with some medium starting currents. Likewise, class D has this range of say about 10 to 20 times the rated current. These are suitable for heavy motors where the surge will be very high, the inrush current will be very high. So you'll have to go for this class of MCB. See, selection of MCB is very important, because if you put a class B MCB for a heavy motor where the surge is more, the MCB will unnecessarily trip only for that surge, which is not the desired for us. So that is why we have to choose a proper class of MCB for a particular application. Likewise, if you see class K, Okay, it is having the range from 8 to 12 times rated current. Again, this is also suitable for inductive and motor loads. Again, class Z, if you take, this is very sensitive MCB. It is suitable for 2 to 3 times rated current. Tripping desired for 2 to 3 times rated current. Something like electronic circuits where semiconductor devices are there. So, I think you have understood some very important fundamentals of MCBs. So, now we will go on to the experiment. This slide shows the circuit diagram arrangement for testing of an MCB. It is very much same as the circuit diagram arrangement for testing of the fuse. I will once again explain the function of various components here. This is a current injection transformer. It is basically a step down transformer. It is having low voltage and high current capacity on its secondary. It is used for creating high current artificially. See, in a normal circuit where the MCB is used, under overload condition or short circuit condition, high current will flow in the circuit. So, we are artificially creating that high current for testing purpose. This is an auto transformer which is used for varying the voltage on the primary side of the current injection transformer. So, this is an ammeter for setting the current. This is the selector switch for changing over from set, between set and test positions. And of course here, MCB and a test will be connected. Now let us see how to conduct this experiment. So initially, you should keep this auto transformer in zero position and put on the supply switch. And then you should put the selector switch on set position. Now by slowly varying this auto transformer, you should apply a small voltage on a primary and observe the secondary current. You will see that even for a small input voltage here, high current will be generated here. So you can set this current in terms of say 125%, 150%, 200% of the rated current of the MCB. Or you can say it as 1.25 times, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times the rated current of this MCB. And what you have to do, you have to set the current by putting the selector switch on set position. Once you set the current, immediately you should change over this to a test position. At the same time, you need to start a stopwatch. So students in group can coordinate. At the time, one of you, when you change over to the test position, other person can start the stopwatch, and you should observe the MCB to trip. At the time of tripping, you should observe the time taken by the MCB to trip, and you should note down the readings in the tabular column. So like this, you have to repeat this experiment for the values what I mentioned, like 1.5 times, 2 times, 3 times, like that. This experiment can also be conducted by using a trainer kit. So these are the meters and components what I explained. So this is the trainer kit what we use for testing the fuse. The same trainer kit is used for testing the MCB also. So you will understand this better by a demonstration video on MCB testing. Now let us watch the video.
Hello students, today I will demonstrate how to test an MCB. I have chosen the single pole MCB. It is a class B type. I have chosen class B type because this will operate between 3 to 5 times its rated current. So because I have chosen a 6 amps MCB because I need not put or supply more current. So I have chosen class B, which is used for domestic purpose where resistive loads are there. Okay, so I've connected the wires like this, and I'm using the same kit for testing this MCB. I've fixed the MCB and now we'll start conducting the experiment. Before we switch on the power on supply, you should ensure that auto transformer is in zero position, selector switch is in set position. Now switch on the main power supply and then switch on the current injection on button. By now slowly by varying this auto transformer, you should set the current to 3 times the rated current of this MCB. I am not setting it for 2 times now, because if I set it for 2 times, it will take longer time and the video length will become more. So I am directly setting it for 3 times the rated current of this
MCB. So this 6 amps MCB, I'll set it for 18 amps. But where the auto transformer slowly, by observing the ammeter, and you set it to 18 amps. So this is 18 amps. Now you switch off the current injection button, off button, put the selector switch to test position. Now switch on the injection on button and observe the MCB to trip. At the same time, take down the time taken for tripping. So the MCB tripped. It has taken 14.5 seconds to trip. After noting down the time, reset the timer, bring the auto transformer to zero position, put the selector switch to set position. So now we'll repeat the experiment to take next set of reading. I am resetting this MCB now after allowing time to cool down. After resetting the MCB, now we'll do the experiment again. Before you switch on the on button, as usual, ensure auto transformer zero position, selector switch in, set position, switch on the power on button, then switch on the current injection on button. Now I'll set the current as 4 times the rated current. So that is 24 amps. I'm varying this and setting the current to 24 amps. Vary it very slowly. So now the current I've set to 24 amps. Now we'll inject this current here. Now switch off the current injection off button. Put selector switch to test position. Now switch on the current injection on button. Observe the MCB to trip and the time taken. So it has tripped in 4.5 seconds. After noting down the time, switch off, reset the timer, bring back auto transformer to zero position, selector to set position, and switch off the supply. So this experiment should be repeated for 5 times the rated current, and then each time you note down the time taken by the MCB to trip, and then we need to plot the inverse time characteristic curve.
So I hope you understood how to test an MCB. So once you conduct the experiment, you should note down the reading of the current and the time taken by the MCB to trip. So after this step, the next step is to plot the graph. Plot the inverse time characteristics graph. You should plot the graph on a log graph sheet. Then you can compare it with the ideal characteristic curve, which I showed you earlier. So I hope you have understood this presentation on MCB testing. Thank you.